The exodus from the city to the country, highlighted in the last two census reports, has shown that more than a third of the population now lives in rural Britain. And according to today's report by the market research group Mintel, 3 out of 10 city dwellers would follow if they could. But if all those who wanted out got out, Mintel says it would turn cities into ghost towns and cause planning problems on a huge scale. In a wet and windy Camden High Street, that didn't stop current or former city dwellers dreaming of a better place.
45% said they hankered after the open spaces of the countryside. 1 in 5 thought it would be more relaxing and less stressful. But more than half said the dirt and the noise were what made them want to leave the city.
It's lovely living in the country. I couldn't honestly say that I'd like living in London. It's too noisy, too many people. It's just lovely in the country.
Would you like to move to the country, given a chance?
Would I? Would I?
Having a garden, having some space. I live in a flat with a balcony and, you know, being able to have a bit of a garden and grow some produce, that kind of thing.
It's much nicer here in Lingfield in Surrey. Just 45 minutes from central London on the train, it's exactly the kind of place many of the city dwellers must be dreaming of.
I know London, I can find my way around London, but no, I'm not sorry to leave, no.
I wouldn't like to bring up a family in London at all. I don't feel that they would have the freedom, although freedom is slightly restricted here as well. I think it would be totally restricted in London.
The report's author says London and other cities could improve themselves and encourage people to stay.
Certainly, I think some of the improvements that are already taking place in some cities, in terms of greening some of the wastelands, improving traffic and transport as well, those are very important areas in terms of making the city a better place to live, I think.
But it looks like it could be too late for many. Those who can are looking to the country for a better life. John Dowden for Thames News.